Okay, hi, good morning. Assalamualaikum. My name is Ezri and we are from the Glamour Mix team under UNO branch. Okay, so today we are doing a theme of meroti or baking because you know, we know sekarang harga roti pun dah naik. I know it's only by 30 to 50 cents, but if you know, you calculate on a daily basis, if you buy a lot, it will still add up to the cost. Okay, so what's the best, one of the best things lah when you get a Thermomix, you have to try to meroti or baking. Okay, for me, when before Thermomix, I memang the thought of nak baking tu memang ada, selalu ada. I have so many cookbooks about baking, tapi tak pernah buat because it's always tedious. I buat cake lah, but not roti because roti rasa macam susahnya, ya, takut tak jadi. So tak pernah try, but my first roti, a lot of my first is actually with Thermomix because everything is guided and everything dah weigh properly and the setting is just nice that you will get the perfect results. Okay, so before we start, I just want to check out, I also have my team here, Zarina and Arisa. Okay, so Arisa is going to make killer toast hari ni. So killer toast ni is like your typical bread that you get outside, okay, that you can make with Thermomix. So you boleh ganti all your gardenia Massimo bread and you can make it on a daily basis because it's so easy. And Zarina is going to make banana muffin with butterscotch chocolate chip. Okay, and the muffin kalau you buat with Thermomix, it takes around 11 seconds saja untuk mix. Okay, senang sangat and it's a good bonding time with your kids juga because my kids memang kalau I cakap I nak buat muffins, that's it. They are there to help me. Diorang nak letak ni and diorang nak pour the batter semua. So, cuti sekolah is coming. It's the best time for you to also bond with your kids. And one of the activities you can do is baking together. Okay, so before I proceed, I'm going to start my recipe first and kita borak lagi. Okay, so this recipe is called... I dah save this recipe in my week. Okay, this recipe is called bread rolls with condensed milk. Okay, so you boleh search dalam Cookidoo. We have right now, I think like 70 plus, okay, 76,000 recipes. Okay, so you just save the recipe in your week. Kalau you nak buat the whole week, the whole month in planning pun boleh. And then you just press start cooking. Okay, so this recipe, I actually made a batch dah semalam sebab I takut tak sempat siap hari ni. So today punya batch, I'm going to half the recipe. Okay, so with Thermomix ni, kalau you nak half the recipe boleh, kalau you nak double the recipe pun boleh. So if you are not sure, contact your advisor and just seek for her advice. Okay, if the recipe boleh ke, you nak potong or you nak double or even triple, sometimes recipe boleh juga. Okay, so this is guided. I'm just going to follow. Okay, so when you press start, dia akan straight away keluar the measuring scale. Okay, so one good thing about Thermomix ni, you akan save a lot of time because you don't have to weigh separately before you start using. Okay, you can just weigh as you go. So I dah pre-weigh all my ingredients because I nak cepatkan lagi, but if I'm not doing this show, I will just ambil straight from my bekas ke apa semua letak terus dalam ni. Okay, so we need 120 grams of milk. I dah half kan, so this is 60. Okay, so just press next and then water 120 juga. I dah half kan juga, 60. And then insert measuring. Okay, so here dia dah set 3 minutes, 37 degrees and then dia suruh turn to speed 1. Okay, but my milk and water ni dah actually dekat room temperature. So, I'm going to bring down the time to 2 minutes je. So, that's a good thing about Thermomix. You can actually adjust, okay, to your own setting kalau you need to. Okay, so just turn to speed 1. Okay. So, welcome to all of you. Can I know anyone kat sini, if this is your first time watching our show, can you type number 1 in the chat room? Okay, and siapa yang dah pernah tengok, welcome back. Okay, and if you are first timer, if you love what you see today, or even if you dah kat sini many, many times, if you love what you see today, please tell all your friends about our cooking show ni and invite them. Okay, we have cooking shows every weekend. Kita ada Saturday 10:30 with our sister T team dynamics, and then ours is on Sunday 10:30 in the morning. Okay, so we change the team every week. So depending what's current ke, what's interesting, we will try and create recipes to, you know, to suit that team. Okay, I just want to share a few tips. Okay, because before Thermomix ni, I tak bake langsung, but as I learn, you know, kalau you nak bake kat rumah, kalau boleh, try to get the best ingredients because this is for your family, kan? So I tend to spend a bit more on good quality flour, okay, when I bake at home. So I would recommend these two brands, okay? So one of it is called Radiant. Okay, this brand, Radiant. You can buy from Jaya Grocer, ada jual, and then you can buy from the online website, okay, Radiant Whole Food. So I always get my bread flour or my plain flour from there. And then another brand yang sangat famous and very, very good is this box, Red Meal. Okay, I'm sure you've seen it. Jaya Grocer ada, online pun ada jual. So these two brands is my favorite. So kalau I nak buat bread ke, I nak buat apa-apa lah, you know, yang guna tepung, I will usually use this two organic flour brand. Okay, and if you're not sure what yeast to use, this brand Moripan is the best. Okay, so you boleh dapat ni daripada Jaya Grocer or, you know, Bake With yang kedai-kedai baking ada jual. And a tip is kalau once you dah buka the packaging, make sure you put it in the freezer. Okay, so to keep it, so you tak activate lah. You don't leave it in the room temperature because our climate is hot kan, so takut dia third activate. And yeah, so just keep all my ni kat dalam freezer. Okay, so now we continue. So it says here to add. So if you touch the bowl, it's 37 degrees. Our body heat is nice and warm. Okay, so you want to add 50 grams of sugar. So I half that, so just 25. And then 120 grams of sweetened milk. Okay, so condensed milk, I half juga, so this is 60 grams. So roti ni, why I suka is because of the condensed milk. Okay, I ni orang Kelantan, my name is Nick Ezrin. I know not all semua orang Kelantan suka manis lah, but I'm one of them yang suka. Until today, I still makan roti and condensed milk in the morning. Not every day, okay, but some days I do it. Roti and condensed milk. Roti canai pun I suka dengan condensed milk. Okay, and 100 grams of veggie oil. So we'll just halve it. So just follow. So imagine kalau your husband nak buat ni or your kids ke, kalau dia boleh baca, memang dia boleh follow je. Okay, and two medium eggs, so just half, I put one medium egg. Okay, so this is at room temperature. So kalau boleh with baking, always follow the exact ingredients lah. If they ask for medium egg, follow. Okay, if they ask for large, follow juga. But if they don't mention what size, usually it's set at large. Okay, so usually baking they use large, but this recipe dia minta medium. And one pinch of salt. Okay, I'm using Himalayan salt. Okay, and then now it's going to mix. Okay, so dia dah set 2 minutes, no temperature because it's just not mix, and then speed 3. Okay, so and another tip for baking is to have a oven thermometer. Okay, because a lot of times macam ramai orang complain tak jadi ke, or you know kat dalam kat tengah still wet ke, is because the temperature of the oven. Okay, so this is one of the best investments. It's not mahal, you can buy from baking shop or online. So when you preheat your oven, just make sure this is inside and you can see exactly what temperature it's at. Okay, usually it's not what you set. Okay, your oven mesti lari sikit punya. Either dia tak panas sangat or dia terlalu panas. So when you have this, this will make sure your baking akan jadi always. Okay, so this is really good to have. Make sure you have this in your oven. Okay. Okay, so ramai juga yang number one. Okay, welcome. And I hope you will bring your friends, okay, to our next show. Okay, so I just want to share a bit of my story. Okay, before Thermomix, I didn't really used to cook. I mean, bukan jenis yang pandai sangat masak. Okay, I always masak the same thing over and over again. Idea memang tak ada. So always order in or go out and makan. Okay, last time for me, a meal was nasi and Campbell's soup yang tin tu. Makan dengan nasi pun for me, that was like a meal enough, you know, because I was like busy working, tak ada masa semua. So whatever is convenient. Okay, so and when I ada anak, of course, you feel guilty lah if you don't give them really good wholesome food, kan? And wholesome food means you want to cook at home because you want to, you know, you want to make sure you get the good ingredients for your family. So one of the main reasons why I got the Thermomix was actually for my kids. I just want to make sure that I give them wholesome food, that I prepare the food for them on a daily basis. Okay, I tak nak order out dah. I kesan lah diorang, they are growing up kan, so they need all the nutrients that they can, good nutrients. Okay, so last one, we're going to add the tepung. Okay, so this is plain flour. Okay, so plain, or you can use tepung gandum pun, it's the same. Okay, so just put. Okay, kalau ada tumpah-tumpah kat sini, it's okay. Okay, it's normal, tak tumpah semua. You can just lap je your Thermomix. It's safe. Okay, and then now, So I keep it in the freezer. So this is 5 grams of yeast. Okay, and then now it's going to knead the dough. Okay, so with Thermomix ni, now they set at 3 minutes. Okay, kejap je. Kalau you knead the dough yourself, if you do it manually, at least 15 minutes lah. 15 to half an hour depending how good you are. Okay, biasa buat. Kalau first timer, how do you gauge kan? I have no idea. Myself, okay, but with Thermomix it's so cepat. Most recipes 2 minutes up to 5 minutes je. Senang sangat, and then it's done. Okay, so that's my life before Thermomix. I ada banyak appliances at home, but sebab I suka kitchen, I kemas, I end up keeping it in the cupboard. Okay, you keep, you tak nampak, you tak guna. Okay, so my kitchen aid dulu, okay, I guna like, I don't know, 4 or 5 times, and then I sold it off. Thermomix can do just the same. Okay, ada measuring scale and all that. It makes your baking faster and easier juga. Okay, so my passion is right now, I just want to make sure my family eats well and I give them the best food and variety. Okay, so I usually scrape so many recipes to choose from, and even if macam you know, there are a lot of contributors from the industry, so you can try macam-macam masakan Melayu if you like more masakan Melayu. Yeah. If you want to input your own recipe dalam Thermomix now, there's a new function where you can add in your own recipe. So kalau you want to nenek punya recipe, kari ke, asam pedas ke, you can actually add in here and use it as guided cooking. Okay, very, very awesome. Okay, so a bit background about Thermomix. It was this company for WEG. Okay, so Thermomix ni is one of the product under for WEG. Okay, so it's been around from 1880, so more than 135 years. And Thermomix ni, this is the 9th generation. Okay, and it was launched in the 1960s. So they've been around for so long. So this nama Thermomix is not. Okay, it's an established brand and it's trusted and memang very, very good quality. Okay, so do you know that every 23 seconds, one Thermomix is sold around the world. So kita dah borak sini 1.5 hours, how many Thermomix terjual kat sini. Okay, so now I'm going to explain a bit about all the accessories that you get with Thermomix. Okay, you need to know that Thermomix ni is German technology, but French punya. creativity. Okay, what a really awesome combo. Okay, just like our Mercedes, our BMW car. Okay, you know German technology is really, really good, high quality punya product. Okay, they always come up with good products. Okay, so now dia cakap leave in mixing bowl with lid on. Okay, to test, to rest for 30 minutes. So now it's going to proof in here for 30 minutes. Okay, so let me just show you how it looks like. Okay, so dia macam tu. So you just leave it in here for half an hour. Okay, let me check the time. 10:50, so about 11:20, you'll be done. So senang je, okay. If they want you to proof outside, they will tell you to proof. But a lot of people, they actually proof in the mixing bowl, it's fine. So just leave it there. Okay, so all our accessories are high quality food grade material. So you don't have to worry about the punya material seeping into your food ke. They're all tested, they're all safe, okay, all BPA free. Okay, so the first accessory that we have, this is called the splash guard. Okay, so Thermomix TM6 tu kita ada high temperature. So kalau you nak masak macam ikan bilis goreng, garlic goreng, you will have to put this splash gun kat atas macam ni. Okay, this is to avoid oil splatter. Okay, and then we have this thing called the Varoma. Okay, so kalau you suka steam your food, actually steaming is one of the best ways to cook your food. Okay, it preserves your nutrient and then memang sihat lah untuk badan compared to macam menggoreng ke apa. Okay, so I love to steam my food. I love steam my chicken, I steam my fish, okay, veggies semua I steam. Okay, so this is Varoma and dia ada two layers. Okay, ada tray and then the Varoma dish. Okay, so you boleh letak your, let's say, kalau you nak letak chicken kat sini and then you letak veggies kat atas ni. Okay, so you get your layered cooking. And what you do is you letak, you cabut this measuring cup ni and then you letak kat atas macam ni. Okay, so you make sure you have your water kat bawah so you can steam. Kalau you nak masak nasi sekali, you can put it in our simmering basket. Okay, this is our simmering basket, letak nasi dalam ni. And then you can have your chicken and your veggie kat atas. Okay, so this is Varoma. And you can use it to, kalau you nak strain your pasta ke, you can strain. Or you nak jadikan colander, you letak your salad di basuh and then you, you know, keringkan dia, just shake it. And you can even apa, sterilize bottles pun, okay, using your Varoma. So letak bottles dalam ni, 20 minutes, you can sterilize your baby bottles. So this is Varoma. And then this is my favorite. It's called simmering basket. You can cook your rice in here. Okay, 3.5 pots or kalau you nak weigh is 350 grams maximum. And the best thing about cooking rice dalam ni is you get low GI rice. Okay, because when you masak nasi dalam ni, once dia dah masak, you can see air yang kat bawah ni bertakung tu, dia warna putih. So that is your kanji. And it will turn to sugar if you eat. Okay, so if you love to eat rice like me, masak your nasi dalam simmering basket. But if you want to cook more portion, if you want to cook up to 500 grams, you can actually cook rice dalam the mixing bowl itself. Tapi the kanji akan serap lah. So maybe nasi macam biryani ke, nasi lemak ke, you can actually do dalam ni. Okay, so we have a lot of nasi punya recipe that you can try with the omelets. Okay, and we also have this thing called butterfly. Okay, so butterfly ni you guna untuk kalau you nak whip your eggs ke, you nak whip your whipped cream. Okay, so how you use it is just place it on the plate macam tu. Okay, so that's how you use your butterfly. And for those yang ada Thermomix lah, make sure you don't use this fast speed four. Okay, so this one and the simmering basket, don't use fast speed four. Okay, and then we have the measuring cup. Okay, so measuring cup ni ada 50 ml and 100 ml mark kat dalam. Okay, so kalau you are not confident nak pour, let's say, liquid directly into your bowl, let's say you nak buat macam recipe today ni, tadi, so you can pour your liquid first dalam ni, 50 ml or 100, and then you can pour dari atas ni. So you don't, you know, let's say dah ada tepung ke, you don't want to tertuang extra, because after that, you dah tak boleh buat keluar kan. Okay, so this measuring cup. And the last one is our mixing bowl. Okay, so mixing bowl ni is a 2.2 liter bowl. Ada maximum punya mark dekat sini. Okay, so you can see ada maximum punya mark ni. So do not cook anything past that mark. And our mixing knife must always be inside while you are cooking. Okay, so dia ada two sides. Ada sharp side and the blunt side. So kalau you nak chop something, you just leave it at default, dia akan chop. And kalau you nak mix ke gaul your food, you activate the blunt punya side, dia akan use the blunt side, dia tak. So dia tak akan chop your chicken ke your meat, your veggie. Okay, so this is stainless steel, very high quality stainless steel. And you will not serap any smell. Okay, so kalau let's say you nak masak sambal, and after you masak sambal, you do your the pre-clean, and then you nak buat your lemonade, you don't have to worry that the lemonade akan bau macam sambal. Okay, because stainless steel, dia tak resap bau or smell or taste. Okay, so that's our mixing bowl. You can actually buka this whole thing. Okay, very easy to clean. You can cabut the knife, and then you can basuh betul-betul, and then you can pasang balik. Okay. And then last but not least is our motto. Okay, Thermomix motto ni is very very special because the motto is frictionless. Okay, so frictionless means dia tak akan create hubba, so you don't need a fan to cool it down. Okay, so a lot of appliances out there selalu cepat rosak is because diorang the fan tu rosak. Okay, they have to keep it, they nak cool it down. So dia selalu cepat rosak. But with Thermomix ni, you don't have to worry about that. Okay, you if you tahu, a lot of people use their Thermomix for more than 15 years dah. Orang yang use TM31 dah 15 to 20 years still in good condition. Okay, so that's our the amazing motto of Thermomix. Okay. And yeah, okay, the apa the sorry the speed, okay, it goes from 40 RPM or rotation per minute up to 10,700. So if you wanna convert that to our car punya speed, is maximum is around 250 kilometers per hour. Okay, cepat sangat. So that's how powerful our motor is. Okay, it can turn rock sugar into powder. Okay, kalau you nak, when you have your Thermomix, you have to try our lemonade punya recipe, and you can see how powerful the motor is. Okay, and then okay, last before I pass to Arisa, I just want to explain what Thermomix can do. Okay, so Thermomix ni is just like our smartphone. Okay, dulu, zaman-zaman dulu lah, before our smartphone came about, kita akan bawa kamera dalam bag, and then we have a notebook, ada pen lah, and then kalau you dengar music, you have your Discman or Walkman, kan? So we have a lot of things in our bag. But now our phone is everything. We cannot live without our phone, betul tak? Okay, everything is in there. Kalau hilang, memang boleh nangis. So Thermomix is the same. It's your all-in-one kitchen. Okay, so it represents 22 functions and more. And it keeps on adding. Sebab this Thermomix ada Wi-Fi connection. So just like your phone, you update your software, you will get new functions. So the latest one, we have this function called peeler. Okay, so but we have to wait for the peeler punya blade cover to come. And then once the accessory ni datang, they can actually peel your potatoes, peel your apa, macam-macam lah, any skin. Okay, dia boleh tolong peel for the veggies for you. So this one expected early next year. Okay, so from time to time, we get new function. You pay one price, but you get, you know, new functions from time to time. So your value keeps on adding. Okay, so I don't have to have many appliances. I dah banyak giveaway or I even sold it off. Okay, so I only have Thermomix at home. Some people even have two because it represents your stove. Okay, so a lot of people have mostly two or three stoves, kan? So it makes your cooking faster. You can do more things at the same time. Okay, so if you already have one Thermomix and you want a second one, contact your advisor, okay, because we have a program where you can get your second one for free. Okay, so now, dia cakap preheat the oven. So I'm going to preheat the oven. But before that, I will pass the screen to Arisa. Okay, so she's going to show killer toast. So that represents your normal bread that you get outside lah. Okay, so Arisa, are you ready?
Yeah, hi.
Okay, let me pass to you.
Okay. Yeah. Hello, hi, assalamualaikum. Good morning, everyone. So, my name is Arisa, and hari ni saya akan tunjukkan macam mana cara-cara untuk buat killer toast. Benda yang paling wajiblah untuk dipek setiap minggu, setiap every 3 days dekat rumah saya lah. Dekat rumah saya, saya dah tak beli dah roti gardenia atau apa-apa roti putih sebab sejak I ada Thermomix ni sebab boleh buat sendiri. Okay, so tanpa buang masa, kejap lagi kita sembang-sembang lagi. I start dulu, kita start muli dulu dough and then sambil tu nanti kita sembang-sembang sikit lah. Okay, so sekarang ni, killer toast ni adalah resepi yang ada di dalam cookie dough. So kita just search killer toast and then ikut je step by step yang resepi dekat dalam cookie dough tu suruh cakap kan. So sekarang ni, start cooking. I just press start cooking. So the first arahan yang dia bagi tahu adalah grease a loaf tin. So saya guna loaf tin yang macam ni. Yang ini adalah saiz dia lebih kurang lah 19 cm, darab 10 cm, and then dia punya dalam ni pun 10 cm, panjang dia 19 cm. Yang ini saya beli daripada Shopee dan saya sangat suka sangat loaf tin ni sebab saya tak payah spray pun dia memang tak lekat. And then dia sangat tebal. Saya beli dekat Shopee. Alright, so next step is dia suruh masukkan 1 biji telur. Telur yang dia sarankan adalah grade A. And then kita top up dengan susu sehingga 180 gram. Alright, so dekat sini saya ada 1 biji telur saiz A. Masukkan. Okay, so saya punya saiz berat telur ni adalah 49 gram sekarang. Dan apa yang dia suruh kita buat adalah kita top up dengan susu. Saya guna susu Dutch Lady Fresh Milk. Dia suruh kita top up sehingga 180 gram. Okay. So sangat senang ya. Daripada kotak ni kita terus masukkan dekat dalam bowl. Tak payah banyak-banyak benda sangat basuh. Macam ni kan, terus daripada packaging tu kita terus masukkan dekat dalam bowl. Sangat senang. Okay, sikit lagi. Oops, okay. Now, 180 gram. Then, seterusnya, kita tekan next. Dia suruh masukkan 30 gram caster sugar. So, sekarang ni saya ada 30 gram caster sugar yang saya dah timbang siap-siap lah. Sebab demo. Tapi kalau tak demo, kalau hari-hari biasa saya cedok ya daripada bekas gula tu, terus masukkan dekat dalam mixing bowl. So, tak ada benda pun nak basuh. Just sudu tu je. So dia suruh masukkan 30 gram caster sugar. Saya masukkan 30 gram caster sugar. And then seterusnya dia suruh masukkan 1 teaspoon dried yeast bersamaan dengan 5 gram lah. Macam Izrin cakap tadi lah. Ini adalah brand yeast yang saya sangat suka. Dan sangat best lah pakai yang ni. Tak cari brand yeast yang lain. So ini baru lagi. And then kat sini kan, kita boleh aktivatekan scale. So, kita masukkan 5 gram yeast. Okay, masukkan 5 gram yeast. Alright, so ada lebihan ni, jangan buang. Kita simpan, seal siap-siap, cantik-cantik. Lepas tu, kita terus masukkan dekat dalam peti ais lah. Dekat bahagian chiller tu. Jangan masukkan dekat bahagian freezer pula. Saya tak tahulah boleh ke tak, tapi selalunya saya akan letak dekat bahagian China lah. So next, buat roti nanti boleh pakai lagi lah. Dengan syarat kita kena steal elok-elok lah. Okay. So lepas tu saya dah masukkan 1 teaspoon dry yeast ataupun bersamaan dengan 5 gram. Seterusnya kita tekan next je. Tengok, bila meroti bersih je, tak ada pun apa tu comot-comot sepah-sepah dekat dapur. Kita tekan next je. Dia ibarat kita meroti dengan hujung jari je. Okay, so next. Sekarang ni kita nak aktivatekan yeast tu. Then mix semua bahan-bahan yang dalam ni selama 1 minit, 30 saat. Then bila kita pakai cookie dough ni, kita tak payah set apa-apa. Kita just pusing je ikut arahan yang dia dah buat tu. So sekarang ni kita just select dia guna speed 3. Okay, sementara tunggu 1 minit 30 saat ni, saya nak share lah sikit berkenaan cookie dough. Cookie dough ni adalah, apa yang kita panggil, dia adalah online recipe lah yang kita user Thermomix ni boleh guna. Dekat dalam cookie dough ni, ingat saya masa saya first beli Thermomix pada tahun ni, bulan 5, baru 72,000 rasanya, 72,000 resipi sahaja masa tu. Tapi sekarang ni bulan 12 kan? Sekarang ni pagi tadi saya tengok kita dah ada 76,000 resepi. Dan angka ni dia takkan stop kat situ je. Dia akan terus lagi naik. Dia akan lagi banyak resepi-resepi yang Kukidu akan tambah. So dekat situ dah ada plus point dah kebaikan kita beli Thermomix ni. Sebab kalau macam buku kita beli, kita spend dekat buku resepi kan. So buku resepi tu, resepi yang ada yang kita dapat tu adalah tu sahaja. Macam dekat Kukidu ni sentiasa bertambah, dia orang akan sentiasa update resepi. Dan kebaikan dia juga, resepi ni dia dalam banyak-banyak bahasa. Maksudnya dia bukan bahasa Inggeris je, ada resepi tu dalam bahasa Indonesia, ada resepi dalam bahasa Jerman. Sebab apa dia buat banyak-banyak resepi ni dalam banyak-banyak bahasa? Sebab orang pakai Thermomix ni worldwide lah. So bukan dekat region Asia je orang pakai, tapi satu dunia orang pakai Thermomix. So macam mana kita nak guna resepi yang dalam bahasa lain tu? Kita boleh guna Google Translate. Yang ni kita boleh buka Kukidu tu dekat kita punya tab, and then nanti kita ni lah, kita guna function Google Translate tu, tukar resepi tu dalam bahasa Inggeris, dan kita boleh masak dekat ikutlah resepi dalam bahasa Inggeris tu dalam kita punya Thermomix. Okay, dah sudah. So next lagi, dia suruh masukkan sekarang ni 260 gram high protein flour. Saya guna tepung brownie untuk tepung roti Haru Sakura MFM. So, ini saya beli daripada kedai roti ni, bakery. Saya tak tahulah kenapa, tapi saya perasan saya dah try banyak dah resepi, saya dah try banyak dah tepung roti, tapi saya perasan menggunakan brand ni, hasil dia sangat gebu, lembut, lepas tu dia punya crust tu crunchy. So ini Haru Sakura. Seterusnya, apa tadi? Masukkan 260 gram. Okay, saya dah timbang siap-siap jugalah tepung tu. So kita just masukkan je. Tengok, bila ni pun tak sepah, dapur sangat bersih. Kita buat roti. Dah masukkan, and then tutup. Dia kata next, tekan next. Belum. Confident awal tutup. Dia suruh masukkan setengah sudu garam. Okay. So sekarang ni setengah sudu garam. Masukkan je, campak-campak je. Tak ada susah-susah pun. Next, barulah masukkan measuring cup. Okay. So next, seterusnya dia seterusnya yang sekarang ni kita nak uli lah. So dia suruh kita uli selama 3 minit. Senang je, 3 minit, uli, tak payah sepah-sepah pun dapur. Kalau kita uli pakai tangan kan, punyalah lama nak uli-uli dengan sepahnya satu dapur lagi. So sekarang ni kita campak-campak-campak-campak-campak, and then terus tinggal je dia uli sendiri. Okay, so saya sambung lagi Kukidu. And then satu juga, Kukidu ni bagi orang yang baru nak start belajar memasak, Kukidu ni sangat-sangat sesuai lah sebab dia adalah guided cooking. Kita ikut je sebiji-sebiji resepi yang dia suruh. Macam dia suruh masukkan berapa sekian-sekian bahan, kita just ikut je. And then hasil dia memang best lah. Resepi-resepi yang dia share dekat dalam ni sangat-sangat sedap, saya suka lah. So macam-macam resepi yang ada dekat Kukidu ni. Resepi pizza, resepi western, resepi daripada Middle East, nasi Arab, nasi apa nama, macam-macam resepi nasi. Lepas tu resepi-resepi Melayu pun ada. Ada resepi asam pedas, ada ayam kapitan. Lepas tu ada resepi sambal belacan juga. Sambal belacan pun guna Thermomix, sangat-sangat senang. Lepas tu Chinese food punya resepi pun banyak dekat sini. Italian, macam-macam lah. Semua jenis-jenis masakan satu dunia ni semua ada dekat dalam Kukidu ni. Kita just tengok, lepas tu tengok resepi dia, kita list the ingredient, and then kita boleh juga masukkan bahan-bahan tu dekat dalam shopping list. Maksudnya kita boleh generate shopping list daripada Kukidu ni. Kita just tinggal share, and then contoh kalau nak suruh suami pergi shopping kan, So kita just share the ingredient list tu, bagi kat dia. So dia boleh tengok and then dia boleh shopping lah untuk kita. And lepas tu seterusnya adalah perfect meet every time. Thermomix ni dia ada banyak-banyak function dan salah satu function dia adalah sebagai ni lah. Dia boleh kneading, menguni, menguni dough, menguni macam-macam lah. Macam function yang saya tengah pakai sekarang ni lah. Macam yang killer toast ni, dia memang agak macam kecil kan. Dia agak goyang-goyang kan. So jangan risau dia goyang-goyang ni, tak ada hal sebab yang ini dia macam ni kita nak cakap kan. Dia bergoyang ni memang normal lah. Dia ada resepi yang dia tak goyang sangat. Macam tadi kita tengok Izrin punya bread roll, dia tak goyang sangat kan. Macam yang ni dia goyang sikit je. Saya still boleh tinggal lagi lah. Tapi okay, so saya nak cakap pasal dia boleh ada function kneading. Kalau nak bezakan dengan kita knead tangan kan, kita punya lah lama. Kalau nak uli dengan tangan, nak kena uli sampai dia dapat elastik texture tu, sangat leceh lah. Penat lagi nak uli-uli, dengan peluh-peluh lagi, dengan tepung berterabur lagi. Tapi dengan Thermomix, tengok saya cakap-cakap bebel-bebel-bebel, tengok dah siap dah dia menguli selama 3 minit tu. Dia dah siap tu, dia panggil kita tau. Then kita tekan next. Dia kata without measuring cup, ikut je. Jangan derhaka lah dia punya instruction tu. Kalau dia kata macam ni, kita ikut macam ni. Jangan pula buat yang lain. Saya banyaklah belajar daripada jangan derhaka dia sebab masa mula-mula dulu saya berialah macam belagak lah tak nak ikut kan. Dia kata letak sekian-sekian bahan. Lepas tu saya macam takpelah, let's try lah. Let's try buat macam ni. Derhaka resepi, tengok-tengok roti saya tak jadi apa semua. So the moral of the story is kita jangan derhaka resepi lah. Kalau dia kata macam ni, kita ikut je. So without measuring cup, okay next. Kita uli lagi selama 2 minit. Then semasa kita uli tu, dia kata kita masukkan butter, 35 gram butter sikit-sikit. One cube at a time. Saya dah ada butter, 35 gram butter dan saya dah masuk siap. So kita masukkan sikit-sikit dah. Okay. Alright. Okay. Then uli lagi selama 2 minit. Kalau kita dengan Thermomix ni, salah satu yang saya sangat suka adalah kita boleh dapat texture yang perfect dan consistent. Setiap kali kita buat tu, hasil dia akan samalah. Tak ada macam, oh, okay, kalau hari ni buat, roti tu naik cantik. Esok try buat lagi, tiba-tiba, kenapa pula tak ni? So, salah satunya mungkin sebab kita punya penimbang tu, dia punya consistent lah hari. Tapi kalau dengan Thermomix ni, dia punya accuracy tu sangat-sangat tepat lah dan dia memang consistent. Dia punya apa tu penimbang ni, dia punya accuracy tu plus minus 1 gram. Maksudnya kalau lari pun dia punya ingredient tu lari 1 gram je. Tak ada banyak ranat sangat lah. Okay. Then sementara tu saya nak cerita sikit lah. Macam sama lah macam Izrin cakap tadi, sebelum ada Thermomix ni saya memang tak baking langsung. Macam Izrin dia still baking cake kan. Saya langsung tak bake cake ke, biskut ke, roti ke, memang tak adalah dalam kamus hidup saya. Saya memang tak akan buat langsung. Sebab dulu saya pernah try buat biskut. Biskut tu memang keras ke mata. Even kalau kita kembali dengan orang pun rasanya kepala boleh berdarah. Memang tak berjadi langsung. Even saya buat cake tu tak naik. Bantat dia orang panggil. Dia memang soalnya memang tak boleh makan. Buat baking lepas tu terus masuk kantong sampah sebab memang tak boleh makan. Dan nak dijadikan lagi cerita sedih, saya even beli yang premix tu. Premix punya adunan tu pun saya try buat pun jadi sama juga, macam tak cantik, tak jadi dan tak sedap. So saya memang tak buat any baking, saya tak buat biskut, saya tak buat kek, saya tak buat roti. Roti memang tak lah kan sebab macam susah je. Okay, itu kisah saya sebelum Thermomix. Tapi selepas ada Thermomix ni, saya tengok, okay, advisor-advisor, macam advisor saya, dia buat, oh cantiknya roti. And then saya tengok kawan-kawan lain pun buat roti. So saya pun beranikan diri saya try. Mula-mula saya skeptical juga. Saya rasa macam betul ke boleh buat ni kan? Aku ni dah tak reti nak meroti, tak reti nak baking. So saya try. Try. First saya buat adalah moist banana cake. Cake tu cantik sangat-sangat. Lepas tu sangat-sangat sedap dan sangat-sangat moist. Tu satu. Lepas tu seterusnya hari kedua saya dapat Thermomix, saya terus try apa nama benda tu? Cinnamon roll. Ha, cinnamon roll tu pun yang saya dapat sangat-sangat sedap sangat masa tu. So, okay next. Kejap ya. Okay, so sekarang ni dia suruh uli lagi selama 2 minit. Okay, tengok sangat-sangat sedap. Sangat-sangat sedap. Sampai dia uli tu pun tengok saya boleh popet. Saya boleh sembang, saya boleh cakap kan. Saya boleh buat demo lagi. Maksudnya benda ni sangat effortless. Okay, so selepas saya dapat Thermomix, saya try macam-macam. Saya buat moist banana cake, saya buat cinnamon roll. Saya buat toast, killer toast. Lepas tu saya buat so sweet pun. Bermacam-macam resepi baking yang ada dekat dalam video ni saya dah try. Dan hasil dia sangat-sangat tak mengecewakan. Memang best lah. Memang segala kejayaan saya baking ni boleh tengoklah dekat saya punya Instagram saya. Saya ada upload dekat Fanarisa Cooks, saya punya Instagram. Dekat situ semualah saya punya kejayaan-kejayaan baking saya selepas saya dapat Thermomix tu. Sebab macam mana orang kata kan, berbaloi lah. Sebab sejak saya buat killer toast ni, saya tak belilah roti gadisah. Roti putih lah, tak kira lah apa-apa brand. Tapi dah tak beli dah roti kat kedai, buat the every 3 days. Kadang kalau saya buat hari ni, malam ni dah habis lah, esok dah kena buat lagi. Sebab dia sangat fresh kan, kalau makan panas-panas, warm-warm tu memang sangat-sangat sedap lah. Anak saya sangat suka. Dia kalau beli, kalau kita beli roti putih dekat kedai tu, dia memang tak berapa nak makan sangat. Tapi bila saya buat killer toast, ada sosis kan lah, sosis kan dia sangat-sangat suka. Dengan panas-panas tu, warm-warm tu, dia memang boleh makan sampai 2-3 biji. Bayangkan budak umur 3 tahun. Dia kata sangat sedap, lembut, dia boleh makan sampai 3-4 biji. Dia seorang saja yang makan. So kat situ kita puas hati lah. Kita bake guna bahan-bahan yang premium macam macam tadi kan, tepung ni adalah tepung yang macam ni kan. Dia kata tanpa bahan pemutih. So kalau kita beli roti yang dekat kedai tu, boleh jadi tepung yang digunakan adalah tepung yang ada bahan pemutih. Dan kita tahu bahan-bahan ni adalah bahan-bahan kimia yang tak berapa elok lah untuk kita. So bila kita buat sendiri, kita boleh pilih ingredient, kita boleh pilih bahan-bahan yang organik, kita boleh pilih bahan yang tanpa bahan pemutih. And then macam telur pun kita boleh pilih telur omega, kan. So kita boleh spend kita punya perbelanjaan dekat situ lah, rather than kita pergi makan kat luar. Lepas tu asyik buat food delivery, order food delivery kan. So sekarang ni dia dah siap menguli, kita tekan next. So sekarang ni betul ke ni? Sekejap eh. Saya terreverse pula. Okay, so sekarang ni dia suruh kita, ni hasil dia eh. Saya nak tunjuk. Okay. So ini adalah dough hasil yang tadi tu. So apa yang dia suruh saya buat sekarang ni adalah saya transfer dough ni dekat atas baking mat. And then transfer atas baking mat, kita wrap dan proof selama 10 minit. Okay. Lepas 10 minit tu nanti, kita bahagikan adunan ni kepada 3 bahagian. And then setiap bahagian tu kita uli, kita bentukkan menjadi satu bentuk rectangle yang panjang, kita uli and then lepas tu kita gulung macam bentuk kayu balak lah yang panjang tu. So kita terus masukkan dekat dalam kita punya lofting ni. So nanti dia akan jadi 1, 2, 3. Akan ada 3 dough lah dekat sini. Dan kita kena proof selama 1 jam. And then selepas proof 1 jam tu, kita bakar selama 40 minit. Okay, so sekarang ni sementara saya tunggu, saya proof selama 10 minit ni, saya akan pass dulu kepada Zarina untuk punya muffin, banana muffin. Okay, over to you Zarina.
Thank you Arisa. Hi, Assalamualaikum, selamat pagi. Okay, so hi, Assalamualaikum dan selamat pagi. So today Zarina akan demonstrate macam mana kita buat banana muffin with butterscotch chocolate chip. Chocolate chips, okay? So this for this recipe, Zainal gunakan a recipe from Cookido, which is your recipe cooking library. Okay, so dekat situ ada macam tadi Arisa mention 76,000 recipes. So dia akan bagilah kalau kita search saja, dia akan keluar kat situ banana and chocolate chip muffins ni. So dia akan bagi tahu the difficulty, prep time, okay, ingredients dan juga preparation lah, tips and tricks semua kat sini. Alright, so all kita kena buat senang je. Click start cooking. So dia kata dekat sini kita kena preheat oven, Zainal dah buat. And then kita go straight lah, okay. So place, kat sini dia akan bagi guided step by step instructions. So orang yang tak ada baking skills pun boleh bake, pun boleh meroti, okay. So kat sini dia kata place 150 grams of plain flour, alright. So kita ada plain flour kat sini, just masukkan. Okay, so the Thermomix tadi macam as we mentioned, ada its own built-in weighing scale, so sangat-sangat convenient. Kita tak perlu pre-measure lagi, okay? Okay, so remember to always click 10 kalau dia tak 0. Kita nak 0 rice dia. So now dia kata masukkan 120 gram 120 gram butter, alright? So kita ikut aja, senang aja, sangat-sangat mudah. Alright? Dan kita klik next lagi. Dia kata add 100 grams caster sugar. So kita masukkan aja. So macam Arisa kata tadi, kalau tak ada demo, kita tak nak pre-measure, tak apalah. Kita sini kita buat demo, kita pre-measure. So kuranglah untuk nak kemas-kemas. Okay, so now dia kata masukkan 200 grams of pisang lah. Kita punya pisang, so kita masukkan aja. I sliced it. So next again, 3 large eggs. So telur kita masukkan ada 3 telur. Next lagi, 1.5 teaspoon of baking powder. Okay, so kita masukkan je. Dan kita next lagi, 1 pinch of salt. Okay, so kita take 1 pinch of salt. And that's it. Okay, so sekarang ni kalau kita next lagi, dia kata insert MC cup. So ni MC cup kita tadi. So kita insert ke atas. Alright, and then dia kata okay, so for Cookido recipes, dia dah set the time and temperature. So because kita nak mix saja, we don't need to touch the temperature lah. So all kita kena buat is just turn speed selector to speed 5. Okay, so kita pusing aja to speed 5. Okay, so when you hear this sound, means it's ready for the next step. Okay, so dia kata scrape down everything. Okay, so kalau kita rasa macam nak mix lagi sikit sebab nak sebatikan dia, so you can always do it lah, okay? So I usually like to buat lagi about 5 seconds again. Speed 5. Alright, so now kita scrape down again and last step, so easy tadi, hanya 2 step saja, masukkan semua bahan-bahan tadi tu and then now we are going to scrape down and bila kita click next, dia kata masukkan 100 grams of kita punya chocolate chips lah, okay. For me, I guna butterscotch. You can use chocolate juga. Resepi ni minta chocolate tapi I suka butterscotch, so letak aja, click next lagi. Okay, so we are going to mix again. Next, for 5 saat, speed 4. So, kita move aja. Okay, guess what? Our batter dah pun siap. Sangat-sangat mudah, sangat senang. Okay, so I'm just going to show you guys. Okay, so the batter dah siap. So, lepas ni, all we have to do is just masukkanlah, okay? Dalam muffin mold ataupun macam I today, I gunakan cupcake punya cups macam ni, paper cup macam ni. So yeah, and then kita kena bakar at 180 darjah Celsius, okay, for 20 to 25 minutes. Alright, so later I will put that one. So sekarang I just want to share a little bit. So selain daripada 20 functions lain, your Thermomix ni acts as your bread maker and also your cake mixer, okay? So yang bestnya, apa kelainannya is that the as for cake mixing function ni, kita ada the 6.8 touchscreen display ni with recipes given to you. So macam it's like you have your own personalized cooking classes sendiri kat sini. Because you know why dia bagi you a lot of beribu-ribu recipe cakes, okay, and bread. And also bukan setakat dia bagi resipi saja, dia akan guide kita with guided step-by-step instructions. And now not just guided step-by-step instructions, we also have the guided videos, okay? So kadang-kadang kalau kita buat roti atau kita buat cakes, we cannot imagine macam mana kita nak. Just by reading the instructions, some people tak boleh nak imagine how to shape the dough atau shape your pavlova. So now with the guided videos, everybody can do beautiful cupcakes or beautiful pavlovas or you know, even the sophisticated looking breads, okay? Sebab kita dah ada guided videos. So sangat senang. Orang yang tak tahu bake, orang yang tak pernah bake before pun boleh, okay? So really, really awesome. Alright, so and then besides that, it's also your bread maker and you get perfect dough every time. Okay, sebab you will get the perfect knead, okay? So kneading time is as fast as 2 minutes to 5 minutes max, which as we mentioned to you earlier. So memang best sangat, okay? So you can do your own pizza, dough, your own chapati, naan, semua, roti, kila toast, everything, okay? And a lot of cakes from, you can also make your own steam buns, okay? So I want to talk a bit about the four-layer cooking ni. So dengan Thermomix also, kita you will get a steamer, so you can actually steam your food. Macam contohnya in the first Varoma tray ni, you can steam your meat, fish or chicken. So dekat the Varoma dish, usually we will steam the eggs and vegetables. So in the simmering basket, potato, rice, pasta, and lastly kat bawah soup. So kalau you buat a recipe chicken rice, kat bawah ni soup, and then inside here your simmering basket masak nasi, and then you have your whole chicken in the Varoma, sorry, you have your chicken and also your steamed eggs, okay? Selain daripada tu, kita boleh buat mee curry, kita boleh buat 3-in-1 pula. So dekat bawah kita buat kuah, dekat atas kita boleh steam the noodles, sawi and telur. So tiga tingkat lah, alright? So memang sangat convenient. And selain daripada tu, kalau orang yang tak ada oven, you can now also using your Thermomix, you tak perlu bake your desserts or cakes. You boleh gunakan your Varoma, okay? You can steam your cakes. We also have lots of steam buns, steam bread, like kita ada steam wholemeal bread, steam banana loaf. So kita ada banyak cakes, also steam carrot cake, steam chocolate cake. Banyak yang menggunakan steamer dan bukan kaedah membakar. Okay, so siapa yang tak ada oven can now also make really nice and delicious cakes and desserts. Okay. So that is for the four layer cooking. So obviously kalau kita dah buat bertingkat-tingkat ni, menjimat masa dan sangat-sangat convenient lah, betul tak? Alright, so now I want to share a little bit about kettle mode. So getting the right temperature for your food and drinks sangat-sangat penting lah. Alright, so right now Thermomix ni is a special kettle. Again, a special kettle mode. Dia bukan macam kita punya regular kettle where 100 degrees baru dia stop. No, now with the perfect temperature control, kita boleh control suhu kan. So kita boleh preheat our, I mean kita boleh buat baby food, okay, at 37 degrees, so kita tak perlu nak blow-blow and you know, exhaling the carbon dioxide tu tak elok sebenarnya kan untuk the baby, untuk kita lah generally. So now you don't have to blow your food, baby's food dengan COVID sekarang ni, kita tak nak kan our saliva to go here and there. So it's perfect, you can just set to 37 degrees. And did you know that kita punya tea dengan coffee pun macam kita punya tea is not necessarily best taken at 100 degrees, okay? So kita perlukan for green tea, suhu yang paling sesuai, yang perfect is 75 darjah Celsius, and untuk coffee to brew it is at 95 degrees. So if you use a normal kettle, you cannot lah get this perfect temperature ni, okay? So kita takkan dapat that perfect precise temperature sebab apa, kita tak boleh control suhu. But now with the Thermomix, you can even see at what darjah Celsius dia tengah masak sekarang, okay? So very very cool lah, okay? And then kita ada banyak function lain. We have the built-in weighing scale, the dough mode, turbo mode, so you can now make your own you can make nice juices, a lemonade juice, calamansi, asam boy juice tu semua. For only as fast as 6 seconds only, okay? So memang sangat-sangat interesting. yang ni I memang suka sangat, kita ada pre-clean mode di mana dia akan help us loosen up all the dough bits, okay? So macam I buat this muffin ni kan, you use butter, so it's very greasy and dia berminyak, so leceh kita nak scrub, kita nak cuci. So with the pre-clean mode ni, we just set to the universal punya apa? Actually what it does is dia akan detect how much it needs to be clean lah. So you boleh choose lah whether you nak browning, caramelizing punya mode ataupun universal dough mode. So kalau you buat roti, you just turn to dough and then dia akan detectkan how much it needs to be cleaned and then dia akan tolong loosen up all the kerak atau dough bits inside here. So kerja you lebih mudah lah. Alright, and then kettle mode blend is also your blender. Lepas tu boleh terus masak kat dalam. Okay, so we can also menumis inside. And your slow cook mode fermentation and sous vide. So I'll go into detail lebih lagi kejap lagi. Okay, so now kita talk about slow cook mode. I really love this feature. Okay, this function because okay hari tu I buat nasi Arab for my last Zoom demo, and we had to do our own lamb broth. Okay. And yang bestnya, using this slow cook mode, I didn't have to be there physically to jaga api, to berdiri lama and nak tengok, watch the fire, takut my house burn down and stuff. I bangun subuh, time subuh, and then I masukkan all the ingredients, and I start the slow cook mode, and then I boleh sambung pergi solat and rest for a while. Okay, at 8:30, I started at 5:30, 8:30 dia dah siap and dia duduk kat studio jam. So, this machine is a super smart kitchen machine whereby kalau kita tak sentuh dia, dia akan automatically be switched off. So you boleh tinggal dia. Kalau you buat kaya, just leave it, go to the mall and after 45 minutes you come back, it's done. So that's what we want. We want what you are investing is in actually technology untuk menjimatkan kita masa tu, masa itu emas. So kita nak that precious time, okay? More time with the family and all, kan? So dengan slow cook mode ni, you can get beef, you can do your own beef stew, braised duck, okay, red bean soup, and also your braised lamb shank, okay? So the next cooking mode is your fermentation mode, okay? You can actually ferment up to 12 hours. Okay, so sekarang guys, kita boleh buat our own yogurt and cheese. How amazing is that, kan? Tak perlu beli dah. So kalau kita nak buat yogurt, usually kita do malam the night before lah, okay? So kita akan malam tu, esok pagi kita boleh makan. So we just buy the starter. Just search for the recipe. Ni pun you all tak perlu hafal recipe, tak perlu you know, refer to your YouTube. Everything is in here. Search and follow the guided step-by-step instructions and it will guide you all the way. So the next morning, you boleh tidur tanpa was-was, tanpa risau terbakar hangit semua, tak perlu risau. Dia akan you know, do it for you, ferment for you, and the next day you can enjoy your yogurt. How awesome is that? Okay, so and the last but not least is the sous vide mode. Okay, so sous vide ni, if you guys are a fan of steaks and salmon, suka makan-makan western ni, so you can even do sous vide egg, but yeah, so you can actually now sous vide, use this sous vide mode to sous vide your steaks and salmon. Okay, so macam mana cara masak dia? Dia masak in a vacuum sealed bag, so you pour up everything inside. To preserve the moisture, okay, and the flavor of the meat tu dalam that vacuum sealed bag, and dia akan masak pada low consistent controlled water, okay. So kita masak dalam in a water bath method lah, maksudnya dalam air. So dia akan masakkan at a very low temperature, consistent temperature, tapi lama sikit, probably about maybe 40 minutes, depending on the recipe, okay, 40 minutes or 1 hour. Alright, so that's why kalau you pergi kat luar, you tengok kenapa dia orang punya meat so juicy and tender. That is because they use this, most likely is because they use this sous vide method lah, okay? Sous vide mode punya method. Kalau kita yang buat, kita masak dekat atas kita punya pan, dia keras kan, you don't get that nice juicy one because yalah, using high heat, so you actually dry up the meat punya, you dry up your ingredients, your meat itself, okay? So yeah, that's about it. So later, I'm going to transfer it to this muffin mold. I mean these cups, okay? And then I akan masukkan dalam oven. So later, I will show you guys, I'll share with you guys the end final result lah, final dish. Okay, so I'll pass it over to Ezri now. Thank you.
Hi everyone. Okay, I'm back. Okay, so I dah roll the dough and memang kat sini dia cakap, once you roll up the dough, dia cakap situ that the dough will be sticky. It is sticky, so make sure you have enough flour to roll it up lah, okay? So memang sticky, so it's not something salah ke or you letak ingredient salah ke tak. Okay, so I tengah proof now for at least 15 minutes. Okay, so around 11:45 macam tu. And then I will bake for 20 minutes. Okay, but I've done a batch, so nanti I'll show you. Okay, so before we end, I just want to share what you will, I want to know what you will cook. Okay, for those yang first timer or belum ada Thermomix. Okay, if you're here and you've been watching from the start, can you just type in the chat what will be your first dish kalau you dapat your Thermomix. Okay, for me, my God, I made so many firsts. Okay, I did my nasi ayam dengan ni, I did baking lah. The first few recipes was bread, I did muffins, I did cookies. Okay, I was even selling cakes. Okay, I was doing the lemon drizzle cake, and then I was doing the burnt cheesecake. Yang tu sangat-sangat senang. Like the mixing was like, I think less than 10 minutes ke. And then you can sell it easily for around 100 ringgit. And you know, a lot of people actually do business when they sell baked cheesecake, burnt cheesecake in a Thermomix. Okay, so you can type in the chat if you really have an idea what's your first dish that you're going to cook with Thermomix. Okay, so the price is RM6,988. Okay, actual price is RM7,188. Tapi kita ada rebate of 200 ringgit right now, so it's 6988. And if you pay full price via cash or bank transfer, you akan dapat this thermo server, okay? 2.2 liter thermo server. Okay, so this thermo server will keep your food warm and cold for a few hours. Okay, so let's say lah you dah masak soup, okay? And then you nak makan maybe a few hours later, you can actually pour the soup in here. And then it will keep it warm for a few hours. So you boleh masak something else after that, rice ke apa semua. And then when you have your dinner or lunch later, it will still be warm. Okay, kalau you nak keep your ice, keep it cool, as in keep it like you know, still in ice punya form, you can also put your ice in here, you nak ice cream ke. So this thermo server is very high quality. They ada base and ada lid. Okay, this is 360 ringgit. So if you pay cash via bank transfer, you will get this as your free gift. Okay, so kalau you bayar full payment via credit card or debit card, you akan dapat One Pot Wonders cookbook. Okay, this cookbook is worth 160 ringgit. It is one of my favorite cookbooks. Okay, so memang best One Pot Wonders mean you just guna macam ni je. Okay, there's no varoma ke any other accessories. Everything happens in this pot. Okay, so we have recipes macam Thai turmeric chicken soup. Okay, and then kita ada like all these pasta dishes where you cook everything in here. You tak payah nak boil the pasta separately ke. Everything goes in here at one go. Okay, macam-macam best kat sini. Okay, I've tried many recipes here. Okay, olive veggie rice. Okay, apa ni? This is a nice pasta. Fish slice congee. Okay, we have many nice recipes in here. Okay, let's see kalau dia ada nice desserts lah. Okay, so dia punya dessert is bubur pulut hitam. Okay, ada creamy peanut sweet soup, ada taro fresh milk. So this book is free for you if you pay via credit card or debit card. Okay, One Pot Wonders. And for all payment option, if you take full payment or full installment or deposit plus installment, if you host a demo, means you invite 3 to 5 friends to watch our Zoom demo macam today, or you can even invite friends to your home and we go there and do demo for you and your friends. We'll bring everything. All you need to do is provide the space and invite your friends, and you can claim this really awesome Varoma Perfect Fit Premium Varoma Series. Okay, this is, you cannot get this here. Okay, money can't buy. Even if you nak order dari Australia, this is all the way from Australia, you cannot get a set macam ni. Okay, they actually sell things separately. Okay, so you can only get it if you buy your Thermomix today and you host a demo for us. Okay, so what is in here? Memang so exciting. Let me show you. Okay, semua ni means dia boleh fit dalam our accessory Varoma. Kan earlier I showed you. Okay, this is our Varoma. So if you don't have an oven at home lah, let's say, you can actually make your muffin and kukus kat dalam ni macam ni. Okay, so this one, actually this one kat bawah. Can fit in here. Okay, so this is the round one, and then we also have a trivet. Okay, so when you use your Varoma, the rule is you make sure that 20% of the holes are not covered, okay? Because if not, you tak boleh like steam things betul-betul. So trivet ni dia tolong tinggikan sikit. Let's say you have a pan or plate ke, so trivet ni akan menolong dia tinggikan sikit so that dia tak cover all the holes. So this is also included, okay, your trivet. And we have a rectangle muffin mold. Okay, so this one boleh fit dekat atas tray. Okay, so kalau you nak buat dua batch, you boleh letak sekali macam ni. Okay, so you get this one as well. And it can also go into the oven. Okay, boleh tahan juga panas. And then kita ada this two liners. Okay, baking, Varoma baking paper. Okay, satu dia tak ada holes. So how you use it, you can letak kat atas ni. So kalau you nak lapik, macam you nak buat steam eggs ke, you nak buat steam fish, even steam fish, okay, kalau you tak ada plate ke, you can actually use this Varoma baking paper. And it's actually reusable. Ada 24 sheets in each bag. Okay, and the other one is the other holes. Okay, so kalau you nak buat pau ke, you nak steam your pau, your dim sum, you can use this one instead. Okay, the ones with the hole. So this one pun 24 pieces. So you have this two, and then you have the rectangle one, and you have the round one. And then last but not least, you have the tray. Okay, this is the Varoma tray. Sangat-sangat useful. I steam everything, my fish semua kat, sorry, atas ni. It fits perfectly on the tray. This is around 30 centimeter. Okay, so ada nama Thermomix lagi kat belakang. Okay, ada brand lagi. Okay, very high quality, very sturdy. Okay, so it fits up here. Okay, so you will get all this. So how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and the trivet, 6.
Okay, nak pergi swimming.
Alright, so 6. And then you have your, kalau you pay your full payment, you get one of this credit card. Or kalau you bayar cash, you can get in the thermo server. Okay, so you get 7 gifts, and right now we also give away Christmas punya e-cookbook. Okay, ada a lot of exciting recipes in there. So once you get your Thermomix, just ask from your advisor, we will share with you the Christmas punya e-book. So you can start cooking right away all your Christmas dishes. Okay, so this is all included in the package. So make sure you order your Thermomix. This is the last one to get. Yalah, until end of the year, okay? And all right. Okay. And bring home and enjoy your Thermomix. So we have VIP cooking classes for you every weekend macam ni. So you can join us and learn and improve your cooking skills with Thermomix. And you also get a basic cookbook. Okay, so our basic cookbook ada 2 languages. Okay, ada English, and you can choose kalau you want a Chinese one. Okay, so dalam buku ni pun a lot of exciting recipes. You have your dessert, kalau you nak buat your ice cream. Okay, you want to make your pasta dough, your pizza dough. Okay, we have vegetarian. You can make your focaccia, you can make your ice cream, your cakes. Okay, yogurt cake, lemon cake, semua ni ada try dah. And then at the back of the book, there's actually a guide on if you want to blend something, what is the speed, if you want to steam something, what is the weight and speed, everything is all here. Okay, so this book sangat-sangat useful, and whatever recipes in this book has also been digitalized, so you can straight away use the cookie do punya method, okay, guided cooking, and cook whatever recipes in this book. So this is also included in your set. Okay, and then we also deliver for free all over Malaysia. Okay, and we do unboxing service juga. So if we cannot go to your home, we can do a Zoom session with you and unbox together. Okay, and you get 2-year warranty against manufacturing defect. Okay, so this is your whole package. Okay, so all you need from breakfast to dinner is here. Okay, you can browse all the recipes. You can start with, kalau you suka apa, boiled eggs, okay, you can start with boiled eggs in the morning, or nasi lemak, or mee goreng, and then you go to your lunch, you can do a 3 or 4-in-1 nasi ayam ke, or rice with steamed fish, and then you can do your tea, okay, you can have your cakes, or muffins, or cookies for dessert, and at night, maybe you want to have like your steak, your sous vide steak, okay, it's memang sedap sangat, just like going to a restaurant, and then you can have your teh tarik, okay, after your dinner. Everything is in here, okay, all is provided by Thermomix. Okay. So live with Thermomix, okay, of course, when you cook at home means you can get all your family together and sit and have meals together. Okay, and you can do bonding, okay, even if you have to work at home, you can still manage your kids and still do your cooking juga. Okay, and creativity, because we have 76,000 recipes to choose from, that's on Cookidoo, okay, but we have thousands more from our recipe community and from our advisors that we can share with you juga. Okay, auto cooking, auto washing, so you don't have to be in the kitchen the whole day. And right now, my bowl yang kotor dengan dough tu, I'm just going to use the pre-clean mode. Letak air halfway and letak detergent sikit and it's going to clean thoroughly for me. So, I tak payah nak scrub. Okay, very easy. And beautiful clean kitchen. You don't have to, kalau you masak benda-benda, especially masakan Melayu lah, there will be no oil splatters. You tak payah nak scrub. There's, you don't need a hood, okay, kitchen hood ke. There's no smell on your baju, on your tudung semua. You don't have to worry about that. Okay, and investing in good health. Of course, you know, eating at home is the best. You get to control all the ingredients. You buy all the best ingredients for you and your family. Okay, so if you want to, if you know you have no idea who to invite for your home demo or our Zoom demo, you can invite friends yang who maybe don't know how to cook. Okay, so there's no excuse anymore. With Thermomix, we have guided cooking. Senang sangat. Everybody can cook. Okay, maybe friends who have children. Okay, of course, they don't care about what their kids eat. Then, so we have a lot of recipes, options for kids as well. And kalau yang ada baby baru nak start makan pun, baru start weaning, we have thousands of recipes. You can buat all those puree. Imagine the bowl is 2.2 liter. You can do a big batch cooking. Okay, and then maybe friends who are very busy. Okay, friends yang selalu order GrabFood, FoodPanda. Okay, we know that they spend thousands, okay, 1,000 to 2,000, some even 3,000 ringgit, especially if they order on a daily basis, dua kali sehari. Okay, so Thermomix is just 9 ringgit a day. You know, you can spend that money on Thermomix instead and buy good ingredients and cook with, for your family. And cook with your family juga. You can cook with your husband, your kids, okay, have some fun cooking together. Okay, and it's safe. You don't have to worry, okay, about kids on fire ke. Okay, so if you want to invite your friends to your home and get us to go and do a demo for you, do contact us and let your advisors know. Okay, we are here to help. We want every home in Malaysia to have a Thermomix at home. Okay, we know how good it will be and how it can help families. Okay, and if you are interested to be an advisor, just like me, Zarina and Arisa, if you want to learn more in depth about Thermomix and get all the exclusive gifts. You know, we have ways, a lot of ways to win all these exclusive gifts first before we even give out to customers. Join us. Okay, you can get good income, side income. It's flexible and it's fun. Okay, you meet a lot of fun people. Okay, so before I pass the screen back to Zarina and Arisa, I'm just going to show you. Okay, actually, I dah bake a batch semalam. Because I know that I tak sempat kot, because now tengah proof and then after this I gotta bake for 20 minutes. Okay, but I forgot to tell my husband not to eat it. Okay, so memang akan, I nak tunjuk lah, it's quite funny. Okay, so this is one of the batches, so dia actually makan sikit semalam. So after you bake, while it's warm, you're supposed to pour the, this is condensed milk and mix with water punya a mixture lah. Okay, so while it's warm too, you just pour on top and then you can put, if you like coconut, you boleh tabur kat atas. Okay, for me, I'm not a big fan, so I'm going to put it at the side. So siapa yang suka makan coconut ni boleh just pour on top on their own bread tu and then makan. Okay, so this is my dish. Okay, make sure you try. My husband cakap sedap sangat. Okay, like at least dia dah koyak ni. At least dia makan, dia cakap sedap sangat. Okay, I had a bit juga semalam together with the condensed milk mixture and it was really, really good. So, the best is you makan benda ni panas-panas. Kalau you nak tuang the mixture tu, you tuang and then you makan sebab dia jadi smoggy sikit kan. But if you want to keep it for long, jangan tuang the mixture first. Maybe you want to dip it ke when you makan instead of pouring terus ke atas. Okay, so I hope you try this recipe. It's really nice. Try all the bread and buns recipes. Sangat-sangat lembut. Okay, let me just show you. Koyak sikit lah. Koyak yang mana sebenarnya koyak. Okay, so it's really lembut. It's really macam you pergi restoran, memang sedap sangat. Okay, and you know what ingredients that go in here. So you use premium stuff for your family. So you get to enjoy, you can control the sugar. Okay, you can use, kalau you buat cake ke apa, you can use good butter. I like to use French butter juga. Okay, memang you can feel lah, you can taste the difference. Okay, kalau you guna high quality things. Okay, so I'm going to pass to Aisa to show her killer toast and then we go to Zarina. Okay?
Okay, so sama jugalah. I dah bake siap-siap pagi tadi sebab takut tak sempat sebab nak kena toast satu jam kan. Tapi let me show you. Okay, ni yang tadi, toast tadi. So kita bahagikan pada tiga bahagian and then kita susun macam ni. Dan kita biarkan dia proof selama satu jam dan ready to bakar. Hasilnya macam ni, ha, right. So this is my killer toast. Cantik. Sekejap, nak duduk kat dalam dia sekejap. Ha, so selalunya kita potong lah. So ini, ha, nampak tak kat dalam dia?
Wow, cantik.
Alright, so over to you Zarina. Try tau.
Thanks, Zarina.
Okay, so my muffins dah siap. Nampak tak? Okay, so my banana with butterscotch chocolate chips muffins. Okay, seriously, this recipe is so yummy. Today, I dapat order actually 80 pieces of this muffins. Okay, so yeah, kadang-kadang rezeki tu kita tak sangka kan. Sometimes tak plan pun nak bake atau nak sell cakes or you know cupcakes macam Ezrin cakap. Dia pun tak tahu, tak pernah terfikir pun. But you know, people started ordering. So yeah. Here's my muffins. You guys can make it too. Do give this recipe a try, okay? And contact your advisors today. Thank you. Happy weekend.
Okay. Thanks, Arisa. Thanks, Zarina.
Thank you.
Hello. Your advisors you. Will contact you, okay, everyone? Get your Thermomix today. Bye. Have a good Sunday.
Bye.